Gen. Section 2 Biology, Movement Across Membranes. Here are the objectives. Know and understand the processes of diffusion, osmosis and active transport, including examples in living and non-living systems. Diffusion is a passive process of transport. A single substance tends to move from an area of high concentration to an area of low concentration until the concentration is equal across the space. Diffusion expends no energy. Rather, the different concentrations of materials in different areas are a form of potential energy, and diffusion is the dissipation of that potential energy as materials move down their concentration gradients from high to low. Osmosis is the diffusion of water through a semipermeable membrane according to the concentration gradient of water across the membrane. Whereas diffusion transports material across membranes and within cells, osmosis transports only water across a membrane, and the membrane limits the diffusion of solutes in the water. Tonicity describes the amount of solute in a solution. In a hypertonic solution, the fluid contains less water than the cell does, such as seawater. In a hypotonic solution, such as tap water, the extracellular fluid has a lower concentration of solutes than the fluid inside the cell, and water enters the cell. In an isotonic solution, the extracellular fluid has the same osmolarity as the cell. Active transport mechanisms require the use of the cell's energy, usually in the form of adenosine triphosphate, ATP. If a substance must move into the cell against its concentration gradient, that is, if the concentration of the substance inside the cell must be greater than its concentration in the extracellular fluid, the cell must use energy to move the substance. Some active transport mechanisms move small molecular weight material, such as ions, through the membrane. That is a quick summary on transport across membranes for the exam. Thank you. Next video, cell division and sex determination.